Hello, I'm Dr. Shantaram Kani, and I'm going to talk to you about the third module of part one of the set Introduction to Ketonics. This third module is about homeopathy, chakra, and SuJok and the elements that you need to know. But before we proceed, I want to make a disclaimer. This part one of the presentation gives a brief overview of the evolution of super extracts and how their use was integrated with the principles of SuJok, Chakra and Homeopathy. It then provides a broad but selective compilation of information on Ayurveda and its concepts, special vocabulary and pool of knowledge. The selection is from known literature sources and websites and somewhat arbitrary. I have highlighted briefly the key concepts and special topics such as language, Dravya Guna Vidnyan, Bhasma and Ruksha Ayurveda. Next is an introduction to homeopathy, chakra, SuJok and how they can be integrated with super extracts. This part of the presentation also provides broad but selective compilation of information and food and diet. Ideas on how the information may be analyzed and used are also provided. This is based on my education and professional expertise in broad range of chemical technology, my research activities in Ayurveda and homeopathy, and several decades of intensive reading about natural products, nutrition, diet, lifestyle, and their role in all aspects of human health. Overall, this compilation, opinions, and analysis contained in this presentation does not constitute advice or provide any warranty, but is intended to empower the reader to make own decisions and detailed diet plans. The reader must use his or her discretion and assume complete responsibility for the use of information in the book. The reader should consult a licensed healthcare professional before starting any kind of diet or exercise routine, including those recommended in this book. So, let us come to homeopathy, chakra, SuJok and the elements that you need to know. Why do you need to know? Because we have learnt how to integrate the concepts of homeopathy and SuJok along with super extracts to produce superior results. So, we will talk about, we will review homeopathy and the concept of hormesis, very briefly review chakra and SuJok and explore integration with super extracts. And this should help you to understand how to integrate homeopathic properties with Ayurveda, explore and evolve detailed maps of SuJok extracts with chakra and SuJok for advances in user-friendly therapy. So, let us start with homeopathy. Homeopathy really is a process technology and it has a physical basis. Homeopathy was developed by 1780 AD by Dr. Hahnemann. It starts with a mother tincture, which means it is really extract of the herb, and then it is triturated, one part of mother tincture with 9 parts of lactose, to make what is called 1x. This process is repeated 6 times, that is one part of 1x triturated with 9 parts of lactose, and that is called 2x and so on until you make 6x. Now, there is a centesimal scale which is 100 fold, so 6x is equal to 3c, which is now a million fold dilution of the starting mother tincture. Now, this is then potentized with succussion in a glass vessel, taking 1% from the top and diluting 100 fold at a time with 90% alcohol in a series of steps to 12C and beyond to 30C, 200C and 1M. Now, those of you who understand some science will recognize that 12C is a dilution by a factor of 10 raised to 24, which as we know is equal to Avogadro number. Which means conventional logic says that when you go beyond 12C to say 30C or 200C is a dilution factor of 10 raised to 400, and so you cannot really expect to find any trace of starting material by that time. And this is what was fully believed not only by other scientists but by the homeopaths themselves. Absolutely nothing should be left. However, we at IIT Bombay started exploration of this in 2007. And we have now established, to begin with, we use metal and inorganic based medicines, and we have shown that even at 200 C, the starting material is retained, you know, a small amount of course, in the form of nanoparticles inside a silica matrix. And where does silica come from? It really comes from the glass wall that of the vessels that are used for suction. So, you get siloxanes from the glass wall, and it looks like that they will coat on these nanoparticles. And once you form these nanoparticles, we have explained why these nanoparticles will survive this apparent dilution process. So, we have found, or we have established, that in all forms of homeopathic medicines, the starting materials are very much present even at the highest dilution inside silica nanoparticles. This is a major paradigm shift. For the first time, it says that physical entities are present. And as I said, this is due to the flotation phenomena at this part of the process. Now then, let us look at, armed with this knowledge, now let us look at homeopathy again. Homeopathy uses all natural products, all kinds of herbs, all animal products, all metals and minerals as raw materials. This is identical to what Ayurveda does. In other words, both Ayurveda and homeopathy use an entire gamut of natural products. And I use all of them to make sugar extracts also. Now, so homeopathy and sugar extracts have several common medicinal uses. There are other elements which are common, I think. See, super extracts from metals and herbs, super extracts from metals definitely have nanoparticles of the metal, we have confirmed that. But super extracts from herbs, I believe, are also due to nanofragments from the cell walls. In that sense, this is what is common between homeopathy and super extracts. Now, we need to understand hormesis. That is a key basis of homeopathy. Hahnemann started with cinchona extract and he got negative results. Then he went on diluting it successively, and at certain dilution that negative result turned into positive results. This is known as the principle of hormesis. That is, and this is established now with all kinds of modern medicines as well. What it means is, at high dose, something produces negative effect. When you lower the dose, you reduce the dose further, you go into the positive territory. And I think this is the common thing that we have observed with super extracts as well. Now, why? What is there a common mechanism for transmission? Since homeopathy and super extract both work when applied to chakra and SuJok. Why do I say that? Because remember, we have found that super extracts work applied to the back of the palm, which are SuJok locations. But then there is a SuJok map of the tongue, and homeopathic medicines are always put on the tongue. So, I think there is reason to believe that the homeopathic medicines also work by the same SuJok mechanism. In other words, the same SuJok mechanism, and the SuJok mechanism itself must work by directly transmitting signals to the respective organ and system. So, in that sense, I think there is something, a lot of things common between homeopathy and super extracts, and therefore, their integration, I believe, is logical. Now, from homeopathy, let us move to chakra. Chakra or energy centers in the body are also well known in our ancient sciences. There are 7 primary sakchakra on the body connected with glands and organs. Sahasrara chakra is the crown chakra, the top of your head is supposed to connect with pituitary and hypothalamus. Ajna chakra is here between the brows, which activates the pineal, is concerned with eyes and sleep. Vishuddha chakra is at the throat, connected with thyroid and ears or hearing. Anahat chakra is the heart chakra, connected with thymus. Manipur chakra or solar plexus is the navel and connected with digestion. Swadhisthana chakra is further down in the sacral area, is connected with sex hormones, and Muladhar or perineum is at the perineum point, which is concerned with sexuality, ovaries and prostate. So, these are the 7 primary chakras in our body, and what is now believed is that each of these represents a crisscrossing a lot of nerves, and therefore, these are high energy centers, that applying something there, the signals can go in several directions all at once. And then what is SuJok? SuJok in Korean means hands and feet, and there is one Dr. Park who lived in Russia, and he developed these SuJok maps. You can say it is a subset of acupuncture and acupressure. These are stimulation points in case of SuJok located on the front and the back of the palm and feet. Again, it is believed that by appropriate pressures, you can directly send signals through the connective tissue network. Now, in classical SuJok, what is done is that you have a tape, you stick seeds of different kinds or miniature magnets, and that tape is stuck on the particular part of your palm where the seeds or magnet will press, and that pressure sends signals. But in SuJok, they do not use oils. On the other hand, Ayurveda uses large amount of oils in a variety of procedures such as Basti, Abhyangam, Shirodhara and Pidichil. Again, acupuncture and acupressure do not use any oil at all. So, on one hand no oil is used, on the other hand a large quantity of oil is used. So, there is no prior basis to expect that a few drops of super extracts on chakra and SuJok should work at all. But we just explored this under the principle of curiosity driven explorations. We had these SuJok maps, these are available. On the back of the palm is the skeleton, cervical, thoracic, lumbar and sacral spine. The fingers are hands and feet and their joints, and front of the palm are stomach, intestine, meaning internal organs, pancreas, liver, lungs, face, eyes and throat. Similarly, the chakra locations are also pointed out on the palm. Map of brain locations is also pointed out on the palm, and there are similar maps of feet. And therefore, we decided to explore these map locations with super extracts for wide range of applications. And we just explored, that is curiosity driven exploration, we got excellent response. For example, on the skeletal spine points, neck, shoulder, back and elbow and ankle, use of appropriate oils, just a few drops, appeared to relieve pain from those respective areas. Fingers, application of these oils to fingers promoted circulation in arms and legs. Thumb, the Vishuddha chakra on thumb and on the throat appeared to restore heavily slurred speech. Then on the open palm at the Manipur chakra, application of certain oils works on choke nose, and again the center of palm and navel particular oil works on loose motion. So, in other words, we carried out this exploration and we found excellent response from by applying specific oils at various map locations on the palm. So, we now have an integrated table connecting chakra and SuJok maps to super extracts, and a therapy has been created. Now, as you can see, this is an extremely simple user-friendly therapy, ideally suited for all day-to-day problems such as cold, choke nose, cough, loose motion, acidity, pain, eye burning, sound sleep, viral cold and fever. But it is also suited for chronic pain, sciatica, post-viral disease, joint pains post-viral, movement restoration post-polio, and even Parkinson's restoration and circulation in arms and legs. So, the important element of the total package of holistic affordable medicine is available at your doorstep. So, how do you benefit from this? Download on Kindle volume 2, From Herbal Oil Extracts to Affordable Healthcare. Understand key concepts of homeopathy, chakra and sujok. Understand the detailed integrated information connecting sujok, chakra maps and therapy. Explore and evolve more options and detailed maps of integrating use of super extracts with chakra sujok for advance in user friendly therapy. So, this is the third module of set 1. The other modules in set provide you with a background in important areas and prepare you to fully absorb and appreciate modules of set 2. What are the other modules? The first one was a general introduction to curiosity driven exploration system called ketonics. Second one was introduction to Ayurveda and the elements that you need to do. And the next module will be on diet and lifestyle for health and the elements that you need to know. Thank you.